Chester over Culver, 50-27, and the tip controlled by the Cavaliers. Zach Graham in that contest for Rochester had 14 points. Beaver on the left wing, lob pass back door to Carnegie, off the rim, rebound to Leininger. Leininger pushes, lob ahead, stolen by Beaver, picked up by Carnegie. Carnegie for the Cavaliers, runs the other way through the center circle. Now jump stops, gives off to Roberts. R.T. Roberts back to Carnegie on the right wing behind the arc, works against Utter. 2-3 zone by the Zebra defense. Oh, are we running a
man? Yeah, okay. It's man.
Harris has it. Cash Harris high on the left side to Roberts. Bounce pass to Kresik. Back to Roberts. Top to Carnegie. Near side to Harris. Harris with the basketball. He works against Deshaun. One dribble to his left. Now feeds into Kresik. Kresik backs his way and he gets a double team. Underneath the basket. Rises up. Shot missed. Ben Perez grabs a rebound and on the way down falls and travels.
Looks like Zebra's going to pay extra special attention to Mr. Kresik. Utter looks like he's roaming a little bit, and when Kresik has gotten the ball the last two times, Utter's came over to give a double team.
You're going to have to. Kresik is large in there. He's only 6'1", but, man, he fills up. Then we're going to have an illegal screen. Is that going to be on Kresik?
Yep. He took hold of two guys as he's trying to set a screen.
Talking to Mike Schaefer before the game. Rob Schaefer, I'm sorry. You know, this kid was a fullback, middle linebacker for Coach Zahner. And the valedictorian.
Yeah, he's played really well even in these basketball games against us these last couple years.
So Rochester with the basketball, still no score here. About a minute gone here in the opening quarter. Zach Deshaun loses the ball right there. Nye to pick it up in the left corner, dribbles to the left wing. Now top of the key to Leininger. Leininger works against Harris in the man-to-man defense. Back to Nye on the left side. Back to Edder now. Now to Deshaun. Looks at a three, passes it up. To Leininger, top of the key in the middle of the floor. And we're going to have a legal screen now on Edder.
Fouls on Utter. Not quite as vicious screen as Kresik said underneath, but
yeah,
guys have to make an adjustment. They know now the referees are looking at your screening, so you better tighten that game up or you're going to get some quick fouls.
Carnegie high on the right side. Looks in the baseline to Roberts. Passes him up now to Kresik, to Harris. Harris stands behind the arc on the left side. Now top of the key to Roberts. He drives left side. Floater on the lane on the way is no good. Nye grabs the board. He rips and runs. Nye middle of the floor for Rochester. He tries a cross-court pass picked off by Culver. Now to Harris. Harris runs over the defense, and he is going to be called for a block, and that's Nye. Jacob Nye set up for a charge, and he's going to be called for a blocking foul, and that's going to send Cash Harris to the line to shoot two for the Cavaliers.
Yeah, I'm just looking to see up. I wondered if they'd give him continuation. They did not, thankfully. Ball went in, but it looked like it was Nye was in position. I give him credit. He was thinking about the charge. Like we've said time and time again, you can't react and get a charge. You have to anticipate.
So they did count it or didn't?
I don't think they did.
They've got to count it if he's shooting free throws. If they did count that, it should be out of bounds, right?
Correct.
So the officials are talking. The bucket did go, so it's a hoop in the harm for Cash, and he'll go to the line to shoot one. Three officials on the floor, and they had to come to the scorer's table and ask if the ball went in.
Hey, when in doubt, ask Kathy Easterday. She'll figure it out for you. Somebody at that table knows what's going on.
Well, Cash at the free throw line, misses the freebie. Leininger rises up, grabs the board, outlets to Nye high on the right side. Nye across the timeline, now sets up shop, gives to Utter. Utter, down low to Perez. 10-footer baseline is good, and we're tied at two.
That's Ben's strength right there, but the ability to take a guy off the block and knock a 5- to 15-foot jumper down, that's one of his strengths. And Zebra's in a little 2-2-1 half-court trap, now dropping back into man.
Kresik to a cutting Roberts. Now to Carnegie at the free throw line. He rises up, shot too hard. Leininger another board. That's about three now for Liam Leininger. He gives off to Utter, high on the right side. Back to Leininger between the rings, near side of Nye. Feeds down low to Perez. Backs his way in. Leaner on the way is no good. And we're going to have a tie-up down low between Kresik and Leininger. And it's going to stay with Rochester out of bounds underneath their own basket.
You know, one good sign so far already this year is we saw the Zebras have a lot of trouble rebounding the ball last year. Much more attention to detail on the boards. And I know Coach Reinholt prefers the man-to-man defense just for that reason, too, because it gives you more specific responsibilities on who you're supposed to block out. Zebras doing a good job so far.
Yeah, I don't think we've seen any offensive rebounds yet by the Cavs. Utter, turnaround jumper over Carnegie, no good. And the rebound fought for, and Culver comes out of the width. Carnegie now gets the outlet pass through the center circle. Out to Beaver, who holds wide on the left side. To Carnegie, right side to Kresik. He'll take the 15-footer, draws nothing but air. Offensive rebound by Carnegie, who rises up and throws it off the knee of Utter out of bounds. It'll stay with Culver out of bounds, baseline left.
I think the Zebra's okay with Kresik taking that 15-footer. Yeah. Anything off the block, I think they'll be okay with.
Brady Perez will come into the next opportunity. Culver, lob pass into Carnegie. He rises up in the lane. A lot of contact, no foul. Off defensive rebound to Nye. Gives ahead to Leininger. Leininger going to be fouled on the shot. Woo! I thought Robert Stays got a lot of ball there, but the officials didn't see it that way. Roberts fouls Leininger on the drive, and Liam will go to the line to shoot two for the Zebras.
The other thing, too, I think Liam had been wide open on the opposite block. I'd like to see him maybe make that pass and get a layup. Yeah. He did draw a foul, thankfully, but he did have a teammate wide open on the other block.
Liam Leininger with two for the Rochester Zebras are tied at two. 5:20 to play in the first quarter. First free throw is good, and the Zebras lead. Brady Perez will come in at the next opportunity if Liam Leininger hits his freebie. 5:21 to play, first quarter. Leininger's second one is good again, so he'll come out. And Brady Perez will come in. Zebras up 4-2 here early on at Rochester High School. Full court press now by the Z's.
Yep, looks like they're matching up a little bit. Not sure if they'll go for a trap or just kind of man-to-man and kind of get Culver out of an offensive rhythm a little bit here.
Culver with the basketball. Cash Harris against Deshaun. Takes him across the timeline left. Backs him to the volleyball line. Loses the handle. And we're going to have a foul coming on Beaver. A loose ball foul. And he fouled Nye, so it'll be Rochester basketball out of bounds.
Jake Nye at this point, very aggressive, both ends. Rebounded well. He's trying to get some offensive rebounds. His hands have been active on defense, getting some deflections there. Gets a deflection and gets reward and gets a foul drawn on him. The Culver's third.
5:10 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 4-2. Jacob Nye now against the 2-3 zone of the Culver Cavaliers. Deshaun high on the right side to Utter. Utter cross court to Nye. Wide open three, left wing, no good. And the rebound fall for Carnegie comes out of there for Culver. Carnegie rips and runs through the center circle. Now gives off to Harris on the near side. Harris, top of the key, now works to the middle of the floor behind the volleyball line. Drifts to the left wing to Kresik. Right side to Roberts. Roberts, baseline to Harris. Harris against Deshaun, takes his man to the basket. Throws up a shot, no good. Offensive rebound to Carnegie. Carnegie on the left elbow, around the defense, floater on the way, is high off the backboard, no good, and Deshaun to the rebound. Deshaun over the defense to Utter. Austin Utter quickly up the floor, right side to Brady Perez. Brady feeds down low to Ben. Ben, law in the paint, over the front of the rim and in.
Nice job, little brother, looking for big brother there. Good post feed, nice move by Ben. Good soft touch.
Rochester up 6-2, 4:15 to play in the first quarter. Coach Reinhold going back to his bench. Leininger will come back into the next opportunity. Carnegie holds behind the three-point line. Now to Kresik, now left side to Roberts. Roberts feeds inside to Carnegie, backs his way in. Shot over the defense is no good. Nye another rebound. Nye rips and runs. Nye low look pass to Utter on the right wing. Behind the arc, about 10 feet. Now to Brady Perez between the circles and the volleyball line. Left side to Nye. Nye in the corner to Deshaun. Zach Deshaun holds. Feeds down low to Ben Perez. Backs his way in, throws up a shot. Tough shot, no good. Defensive rebound. Roberts rips and runs, goes to the basket, travels, no call, and puts it in off the glass for a layup, and it's 6-4. How about that athleticism, Stays?
Yeah, that was really good.
3.5 to play, first quarter, 6-4, Rochester. Here comes the jump and run, the jump and run defense, and Carnegie kicks it away. It's going to stay with Rochester. Leininger back in, and Jake Nye to come out.
Yeah, both teams trying to mix their defenses here early on to maybe see what you got. It's first game for both teams. You're trying to see,
sure,
I think we can do this. Let's try this. You don't really have a scouting report to go on the other team. You got some familiar faces, but good time to experiment that first game of the season.
Leininger looks to get it in. Does over the top to Brady Perez at the Culver free throw line. Perez crosses the timeline against Roberts. Takes him to the left wing. Now to Leininger. Leininger at the free throw line. Out to Deshaun. Three ball, right wing. No good. And the rebound to Harris. Cash Harris runs for the Cavaliers. Harris loses the handle. Ball loose on the floor. Utter picks it up. Ball still loose. Leininger has it now. Turnover, Culver. Out to Brady Perez. Thought about a three. Now to Deshaun. Right baseline three is off the mark. No good. Carnegie with the rebound. Carnegie pushes for the Cavs. 6-4 Rochester. Three to play in the first quarter. Out to Cash.
Lots of effort, lots of hustle, but you can tell it's the first game.
Beaver's layup no good. Kresik's putback is good for the Cavs, and we're tied at six. 2:45 to play, first quarter. Tied at six. Leininger high on the right side against the double team. And he's going to be fouled about 25 feet away from the basket. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester on the far sideline. We're tied at six. 2:40 to play in the first quarter.
That's the fourth team foul. Four of the five starters for Culver have a foul. Cash Harris, the only one who does not. For the Zebras, Nye and Utter each have one. Little helter-skelters right here. That looks good. You know, the guys are both playing hard on both teams, but little ragged around the basket. Can't quite finish those shots within 5 feet.
Ryle, a 5'11 junior in the game for the first time for the Cavs. Ball picked off and stolen by Cash. Cash ahead to Carnegie. Look out. He lays it up and in. And they call her back up 8-6. Hunter crosses the timeline to Leininger, and Culver stays, has picked up the defensive intensity here a little bit. Hunter on the right wing. Lawson holds against Carnegie, takes him baseline, runs him over, and it's going to be called for a foul. That'll be Austin Hunter's second personal. 2:13 to play in the first quarter, and that's going to send Coach Reinhold to the bench, and Jacob Nye will come back into the game.
Yeah, tough on Utter. He's trying to make a call, but the Culver man was there, ready to take a charge.
So Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the first quarter. Culver's back up here 8-6, and after the Zebra timeout, it'll be Culver basketball going to our right. Rochester now will put a little four-court press action.
I think both coaches probably appreciative of that little timeout there.
Yeah,
it was,
let them catch their breath.
Yep,
a little.
Yep.
Carnegie, 6'5", runs the point for the Cavaliers. Takes Perez to the top of the key. Now outside to Cash. To Roberts, high on the left side, now to Cash in the center circle. Cash fakes a pass out of Carnegie. Way outside. Now to Ryle. Ryle against Jake Nye, the man-to-man defense. Ryle in the center circle. Wrap around pass to Roberts. Near side to Carnegie. Feeds down low. Ball loose. And Ben Perez saves from going out of bounds.
Oh.
Right in the hands of Carnegie. And as Carnegie's going to the basket, he is fouled by Brady Perez.
Brady's first, team's fourth. Nice hustle by Ben to keep it alive. Just couldn't quite tap it to a Zebra player.
1:46 to play first quarter. The Cavs by two. Their basketball baseline right. Harris gets it into Carnegie. Out of Roberts. Back to Harris in the lane. Fall away jumper in the paint is no good. In and out. And the rebound to Nye. Nye with another board. He brings it up the floor for the Zebras. Through the center circle. Bounce pass to Perez. Down to Brady Perez. His layup is good. Then to Brady, and we're tied at 8.
Best part about that, two bounce passes. Gotta love it. Gotta love the bounce pass.
Under 90 seconds to play. First quarter. Tied at 8 here at Rochester. Cavaliers with the basketball. Right side to Ryle. Ryle. Wrap around pass to Kresick. Being double teamed. Kicks it out to Roberts. Roberts fakes right. Goes left, throws up a shot, foul on the lane. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's going to be on Zach Deshaun, looks like. Yes, Zach's first, team's fifth.
So, going to the line will be R.T. Roberts, a 6-foot junior for the Cavaliers. Again, we're tied at 8 here at Rochester, with a minute 14 to play in the first quarter. Roberts eyes the first one. Too hard off the back of the rim, he'll have one more. Lady Zebra shot free throws really well last night, 21 of 31, which was the difference.
Getting there.
Yeah.
Yep, we like that number.
Roberts with one more for the Cavs. Eyes a second one, and this one goes in, 9-8, Cavaliers.
Culver one of three from the line so far, Zebras two of two.
Okay. Nye through the center circle for the Zebras. 2-3 zone by the Cavaliers to Brady Perez. High on the right side of Leininger, and his pass is tipped away and stolen by Ryle. And Ryle then, woo. Throws it off the official's hip, which saved him going out of bounds and right into the hands of Roberts. To Cash. Cash Harris goes to the basket. Before the shot, he's fouled. It'll be out of bounds to the Cavaliers. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
Yeah. But you know what I found? Those things tend to even out. Keep playing hard, and good fortune usually follows.
Cash will look to trigger it in. Baseline left. Cash, bounce pass in. Kresick, and was it a kick?
Just out of bounds? Maybe just, yeah. Must have been a kick.
Yeah. Must have been a kick on the Zebras. Harris will try it again. Carnegie rises up, lays it off the backboard, and it goes through, and now the Cavaliers up 11-8 with 40 seconds to play in the first quarter. Nye high on the right side.
Inside's opening up a little more for Culver. They seem to be pounding the ball a little more.
Another turnover by the Zebras. Roberts has it now with 31. Out of Harris, just floored in the lane. A lot of contact, no foul. Ben Perez on the floor, and then the pass is deflected. Kresick picks it up. Kresick on the baseline with 20 and loses it out of bounds. He's going to go back to the Zebras. It stays Are we calling charges this year or not?
I've seen one
in 17 games.
I don't know. I haven't seen any. Like I told you last night, I'm about ready to tell the girls, no, don't take a charge until it's at the very end. The risk reward of that is it's not there this year. So Zebras dealing with a trap by Culver. Going to try to pass out of it. Good look from Ben to Brady.
Ben Perez, no good. 6 seconds. Carnegie rips and runs with four. Carnegie with three. Carnegie coast to coast. Blocked by Ben Perez. Picked up. And a full court shot by Deshaun is no good. After one, Carver leads 11-8. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Going to the second quarter with the Cavaliers leading here at Rochester High School 11-8. And the Cavs will start the second quarter of the basketball. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
9-4 is the turnover numbers. I was off a couple. Thanks to Val for the assist.
That started to pile up for the Zebras when Culver went to that run and jump.
They did, and I think I was maybe a little bit tired. That's the other thing Coach Reinhold and I were talking about. You know, scrimmage Oak Hill is, you know, that conditioning. What's the right amount trying to get all your stuff in for the first game, too?
Carnegie loses the ball and gets it back, and then Rochester has it on a turnover to Brady Perez. Perez rises up, shot, good, and a foul!
Nice move. And I also like how the Zebras are trying to push the ball, looking ahead. They get a rebound, turnover, trying to push the ball up this year.
So I was told before the game, we're going to see a dunk tonight, and it's going to be out of 23 in white. And when Brady got that on the breakaway, the entire bench stood up and ready for a flush. He laid it in, got fouled while doing it, and he'll go to the line for one.
He can do it.
I saw in the pregame. So Perez at the line for one, looking to tie this one up at 11. Free throw is good.
But you know what about that? You get the same amount of points for a layup.
Oh, come on. Not near as exciting.
Saying a guy who never dunked before in his life. I'll take three.
Harris to Roberts, back to Harris between the circles. Swings right side to Ryle, back to Harris. Rochester in a 2-3 zone now. Roberts, cross court to Ryle. He'll fire a three from the right wing. No good air ball. Kresick's put back is good on the weak side. The Culver back up 13-11.
Yeah, that's a good thing about a zone is you cut off the driving lines. But the tough thing is you got to find your rebounding responsibilities. A little bit tougher than when you're playing man-to-man.
Better for three is in and out. No good. Leininger's rebound. He puts it back up underneath the backboard. No good. Ryle the rebound. And Leininger just picked up a frustration foul.
Yep.
With 7:10 to play in the first half.
Nice move by Lamy. Pump faked a couple times, thought he was going to get it to go in. His arms just weren't quite long enough. And that's just one where he's trying to make a play.
Yep.
And unfortunately picks up a foul. But it's only his first, but team seventh. So Culver will be shooting free throws on every foul the remainder 7:10 of this quarter.
Ryle at the line to shoot. One in the bonus. The Cavaliers already up 13-11. Ryle ready. Right-handed free throw shooter. Fires the first one. And it's good as it rattles in. He'll have one more. How about those Mastodons?
Yeah.
That's a big win.
The coach said, I give Crean credit and IU credit for going to Fort Wayne and playing. I'd like to see more of that. Of course, they won't now that there's an upset because you don't want to be the Sports Center highlight if you're the major school. But
Appalachian State all over again.
As a basketball fan, I appreciate the big guy going to the little guy.
14-11. Culver makes one of two on that trip. Out at the left elbow. Out to Leininger. Leininger between the ring. Now to Brady Perez. Now to Hutter at the left elbow, and he is fouled on the reach-in by the Cavs, and Rochester now will shoot free throws from here on out.
Yep, free throw contest, remainder of the half. It's fouls on R.T. Roberts, his second, team sixth.
Schumann In and coming out is Roberts with two personals. Brady Perez will trigger it in, baseline left. Brady, ball above his head looking. Oh. Over the top of the defense to Nye. Nye against the man-to-man defense. Stands top of the key and drives it left. Hands off to Leininger with 6:45 to play in the first half. Leininger in the paint. Backs it out now. Gives to Utter. Utter for three straight away. Nope, too hard. And the rebound to Ben Perez. Ben gives to Brady, now to Leininger. Now to Utter. Utter again from straight away. No good. And the rebound to Nye. And Nye has it taken away by Culver. And we're going to have a tie-up. Zebras will keep possession.
I've seen Utter shoot a few times in my life. Just doesn't look as confident, not as smooth. Of course, when he missed that first one, take that second one. He needs that first one to fall. A very confident shooter, but not confident right now.
Yeah.
Zebras do a good job moving the ball, keeping those hustle plays, keeping the basketball alive. That's a good sign.
Three offensive rebounds on this trip. Brady Perez will look to get it in, baseline right. Brady throws in the backcourt.
Go get it.
And
it's going to
be Liam Light.
Liam,
you and Leininger just tipped it out of bounds.
I think he could go get that. That was a tip ball.
Does it matter if we tipped it?
There's no clear possession.
Okay.
Yeah, no clear possession.
And so, I'm sure that's what Coach Reinhold's talking to him now. Yep, Culver Cavaliers basketball baseline left. Harris will look to get it in. Harris, Kresick rises up from 10 feet and gets it to go. Cavs now by five, biggest lead of the game at 16 to 11.
Kresick at six.
6:16 to play in the half. Coming a half up at halftime, Rochester Wrestling Coach Clint Guard. They've got a tourney under their belt last weekend. We'll talk to him. Wide open, Ben Perez. Good look by Utter. And Perez has two more. It's 16-13. And now we'll have a Culver timeout. It'll be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Six minutes to play in the first half. Cavaliers leading 16-13, and after Culver's timeout, Cavaliers have the basketball. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. First guy's game of the year. Carnegie.
Zebras going to a little trap.
Yep. Down low to Schumann. He loses the handle. Nye fights for it. We're going to have a tie-up, and Culver will keep possession.
Good scramble there. I think that's another dimension we're seeing in the Zebra defense this year. You've got some very athletic guys out there, a little bit stronger this year.
I like
being able to get after it. Yeah, just mix and max your defenses here a little bit.
Harris baseline right for the Cavs. Gets into Carnegie. Carnegie fakes a shot, drives, pull up jumper from 5 feet, no good. The putback, no good. Schumann puts it back up for the second time and it goes. 18-13. 5.5 to play in the first half. Nye loses the basketball in the backcourt. Picks up his dribble, now to Utter, and Utter is going to be fouled by Carnegie, and that's going to send Austin Utter to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
Carnegie's second, team seventh. Hopefully Utter can get off the schneid here, get this, get these free throws to go, and sometimes that's all a shooter needs to see is a ball go through the hoop and get warmed up a little bit.
Beaver back in, and Carnegie comes out with two personals. Austin Utter at the line, a 6'5 junior for the Zebras. Flies the first one, no good. And the rebound to Harris. Harris then bounces it off his knee and right into the hands of Ryle. Down low to Schumann. Schumann leaner against Brady Perez and it goes in. And now the Cavs up by seven. 20-13, Brady Perez now runs a point for the Zebras. Walks it through the center circle. Bounce pass to Deshaun. Deshaun high on the right side for the Zebras. Gets a pick from Utter. Out to Austin on the right wing, down low to Brady Perez. Brady uses his body to shield the defender, and it goes in for two more.
How about Ben?
Ben, yep, beg your pardon, Ben Perez with two more, and it's a five-point lead now for the Cavs. Beaver to Harris, back to Beaver on the right wing. Man-to-man defense, now make that 2-3 zone by the Zebra defense to Ryle, and he travels going to the basket. 4:47 to play in the first half. 20-15, Cavaliers.
See if Zebras try to keep going back into Ben. They're going to get run and jump trapped again.
Handled it better this time.
Yep.
Nye off the side of the backboard. And now we're going to have a hustle foul whistled against Zach Deshawn, and that's going to send Harris to the line to shoot. One in the bonus. Liam Leininger will come back into the game.
Ugh. Zach's third. Team eighth. Another unlucky bounce, trying to get that diagonal skip pass, hits the backboard, ends up with a turnover, then a foul. Unfortunately, Zach's third.
Zebras playing a little shorthanded tonight. They've got basically six with a couple of JVers. Zach Graham, a huge game tonight. Offensive rebound after the missed free throw to Beaver. Ryle for three, right wing, off the back of the rim, no good. Brady Perez rises up, grabs the board, and sends it ahead to Leininger. Leininger, right-handed layup is good. Great work by Brady Perez. Of course, he did that the entire football season. And it's 20-17.
He's third baseman baseball pitcher, too.
The reverse layup by Ryle goes.
Number 23, Ryle.
Be your number one this year?
Carter Hooks.
Oh, boy, Brady Perez traveled and got away with it. Shot no good. The putback by Perez is no good. And the rebound to Schumann, who gives it to Harris. Harris runs up the floor. Culver going to our right. Ryle fakes, rises up. Got Zebras off their feet.
Yep.
Foul on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Doesn't take much. Sometimes just need a little shoulder fake. Just got to get that head pump, ball fake a little bit. Got him up in the air. That's all you need to do is draw a foul. Ben's first. Team's ninth.
So Ryle at the line to shoot two for the Cavs, who lead 22-17. The first one is off the back of the rim and in no good. Cavs could be probably upstaged by about 10 if they make their free throws here.
Free throws and shots within 5 feet.
Yeah, good call.
They've had some good looks, especially late in the first quarter.
Ryle's second one is good again, or good this time. 23-17. Cavs by six, 3:45 to play in the first half. Hunter hesitates, and now Beaver riding down the floor is going to be whistled for a foul, and Austin will go back to the line to shoot one of the bonus for the Z's.
Well, I get the chance here. Just want to wish a happy 15th birthday to Trey Stasiak.
Really, today?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. Feeling a little bit older today.
Amen. Hunter's first free throw. Nope, too hard. And the rebound tipped away. Brady Perez right there to grab it. Ball loose. Harris comes out of the with it. Gives to Kresik.
Boy.
Now to Harris.
Hunter just can't buy one.
Yeah. A little bit too hard the last couple of free throws. Beaver on the right wing, now to Harris, quickly left side to Ryle. Rides the baseline about 15 feet away, kicks it outside to Harris. The left wing, right wing pass to Beaver, rises up, feeds down low to Schumann, backs his way in. Spinner against Ben Perez, and he is going to be fouled on the shot by Perez, and Schumann will go to the line to shoot two.
That foul's on Ben. It's a tough call when the offensive guy's spinning and fading away to draw that foul. Looked like he had a pretty good position. Schumann can go to the line. He's had a productive quarter.
3:20 to play in the first half. Schumann's free throw is good as it hits the front of the rim, the backboard, and rolls in.
It's his fifth point off the bench here this quarter.
Gary Plummer about to check in, a 6'5 sophomore. And he'll replace Ben Perez, who has two personal fouls. Ben's had a good half scoring-wise. Has played a good first half all the way around.
He has been very active. That's what you expect for your senior that's got some experience on the inside. Well, kind of intrigued by Mr. Plummer. See what he can do at the varsity level. He's got the size, that's for sure.
Schumann's second one, no good, and we're going to have a... Is there going to be a foul or in the lane too soon? There's going to be a foul against Kresik, and Zebras will shoot.
Yep. Just kind of, you know, that's what you get now that they've allowed, the players to enter the lane upon the release of the free throw. You're going to get a little more physical activity, which I'm glad that they are allowing that because, you know, before when you had to wait till it hit the rim, it was such a crapshoot and randomness that I think you can actually teach the block out once again on the free throw.
Brady Perez way too hard in the rebound to Harris. Harris, under the direction of Coach Kruger, says it slows it down just a bit. He crosses, walks it through the center circle. 3:10 to play in the first half, a cast by seven. Ryle, baseline to Schumann, feeds down low to Stevens. Stevens back to Harris, fakes a pass, now right wing to Howard. Back door to Stevens, the freshman rises up, short shot and rebound to Plummer. We're going to have a tie-up. Rochester will get possession.
You know, this is one of those scenarios we saw quite a bit last year where the Zebras would hang close in the second half and they'd come to the end of that second quarter and it seemed like they're right there and then couldn't quite close the gap.
Cavaliers will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. To play in the first half. The Cavaliers leading 24-17, and the Cavs, after their second time out of the half, I believe will have the Rochester will have the basketball, don't they?
On their own possession. Foul trouble's mounting for both teams.
Yep.
RT Roberts with two, Lance Beaver with two, Nick Carnegie with two, Josh Krissick with two, Cash Harris for one, and for the Zebras, Utter has two, Deshaun has three, Ben Perez has two, Leininger and I have one, Brady Perez has one. Culver coming out in a 2-3 zone.
Brady Perez high on the right side. Pass is tipped away, stolen by the Cavs. Steven gives to Schumann. Schumann, now to Howard. Bailey Howard will walk it up, and he'll give to Harris. Cash Harris just holds right in front of the Rochester bench, and that 2-3 zone extended out to the volleyball line. Harrison's left side to Ryle. Ryle back to the center circle.
I'm going to say with four starters with two fouls, I'm not sure Culver's going to be in a hurry if the Zebras are going to play 2-3 zone, try to make it to halftime with the lead.
Yeah, exactly. I was going to say, and they lead by seven. Ryle back to Harris, and Rochester make that Culver, like Stay said. Yeah. Just kind of running the clock here, and Leininger's quick hands forces a turnover. Rochester has it down by seven, 2:05 to play in the first half. Utter now, top of the key. Austin thought about a three, passes it up, now to Leininger on the right wing, in the right corner to Nye. He'll fire a three, right baseline, good! And that lead now down to four, yep, with a minute 50 to play in the first half.
Zebras had some good looks at three. That's the first one go down. Zebras going to switch it up, come out man-to-man.
Harris to Howard on the right wing. Now to Ryle. Ryle to free throw line. Back to Howard. Looks baseline to Stevens. Can't get him. Now to Harris. In the middle to Stevens. Stevens to Howard on the right wing, behind the arc on the right side. Now to Schumann. Schumann leaning over the defense, high off the glass and good.
The young man has 7 points all in the second quarter off the bench.
Yeah, he didn't come into the second quarter.
Yeah, big numbers for Culver there. That's a big assist to the Cavs.
Minute 20, LaPass goes right into the hands of Schumann, and he hands off to Harris. Minute 15 to play in the first half. The Cavs by six at 26-20. And Harris walks it through the center circle. Man-to-man defense now by the Zebras. Schumann to Ryle. Ryle around the defense, near side to Howard. Bailey Howard against Brady Perez. Out to Schumann, to Harris, under a minute to play in the first half. Howard to the basketball, right wing pass to Ryle, feeds down low to Schumann, backs his way in. Leaner on the way is no good, but before the shot, we're going to have a travel, and it'll go back to the Zebras with 48 seconds.
Yep, Zebras down six. Not sure they'll necessarily try to get, I guess, look for the best shot you can get. Don't have to force anything, but something comes with the rhythm of the offense.
Brady Perez now to Utter on the right wing with 37. Back to Perez. Brady holds with 34. Now drifts to the right wing. Gives him the corner to Leininger with 30. Down low to Utter. Utter fakes. Fall away jump on the baseline's no good. And Cash Harris with the rebound. 22 seconds. Harris now accelerates around Nye. Behind his back dribble. Left wing. 18 seconds. He loses the basketball. Picks up the handle. Now to Howard with 12. Back to Harris. Harris down low, has this pass taken away by Utter with nine. Now to Nye with seven. Nye across the timeline with five. Nye at the lane, down low, taken away by Ryle. Half court at the buzzer by Schumann on the way.
He lost a good guy when he stepped down from the girls program.
Absolutely.
Rochester will start to Sean Leininger, Nye, Ben Perez, and Utter, their original five. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Rochester starts to know. Man-to-man defense, and Jake Nye in the jersey of Beaver
deflects the basketball, and they're going to say last touch by Rochester. And they'll stay with Culver. Yep.
Yep. I thought the Zebras' man was good. Took care of rebounding, which was an issue before. Took care of rebounding, got him in a little foul trouble, but we'll see if the Zebras can't get back and lock it down. It is only a two-possession game. They're playing much better on the defensive end already this year.
Carnegie gets it in to Harris, and Harris walks it through the center circle. High on the left side of Carnegie. Carnegie got a lot of rest in that second quarter because of foul trouble, as did Utter. Harris to Beaver. Beaver looks back door to Roberts, can't get him, but gives to Harris. Harris drives, pull up 15-footer off the window, no good. Carnegie skies for the basket, or the rebound. He puts it back, no good. Misses the second shot. Ball loose, Culver comes out of the river. Roberts left side of the floor, will go to the basket. His layup is up and good. Leininger right there to, you know, defend the shot and kind of backed away from it. Then on the other end, Rochester misses a shot and Culver the basketball. Roberts in the paint. Leaner on the way, short. Rebound fall for Utter, comes out of there with it. And now Utter clears an eye.
See, Zebras slow the game down, get in the rhythm of the offense.
And Deshaun has his pass kicked away. Brady Perez comes back into the game. And who's coming out?
Zach.
Deshaun will come out.
Probably a little coachable moment there for Coach Reinholdt. Yep. You know, that last shot Zach took off, balance floater, first pass of the offense. You know, you're only down 8 points. You like to get a few touches here these first few possessions of the second half.
Leininger has his ball tipped away and stolen by the Cavs. Harris quickly up the floor. Harris kicks it out to Carnegie. Carnegie accelerates, goes to the basket, and the shot no good. Rebound by Kresick, and then Kresick is fouled on the floor. It'll be out of bounds for the Cavs. You know, one thing that you kind of talked about here, and Coach Reinholdt talked about in the pregame show, was all we want to do is get shots within our offense.
Mm-hmm.
And many times they've done that, but there have been some times that the kids have rushed a shot.
Yeah, and that's just, again, recognition and understanding about, hey, it doesn't have to come all at once. You know, we've talked about this too. It's not a 5 second shot clock, it's not a 10 second shot
yep.
clock. Move the basketball. It's amazing. The more touches you get, sometimes the better shot
well,
you get.
And it's really hard to play defense for 30 seconds.
Yeah, who likes to do that?
Yeah. Beaver, left corner for the Cavs. Beaver bounce pass to Roberts, right side to Carnegie. Rochester, the man-to-man defense to Roberts. His leaner over Ben Perez, no good, but Ben Perez just picked up foul number three and kind of lipped off the official a little bit.
Stop coming on Zebras, number 40, Ben Perez.
Yep. And going to the line is Roberts.
Ben was in decent position. I think he just got to be willing to stand there and take it. He kind of was backpedaling a little bit.
Yep.
Didn't quite sell it. But as we said, we haven't seen too many charges called anyways this year, so maybe best to do the matador and get out of the way.
RT Roberts, free throw's good. Rochester make that to the Cavs now by 9, and with this freebie, with an opportunity to push it to double digits. Roberts eyes the second one. And he misses it. Rebound to Brady Perez. Brady rips and runs to the Zebras. Brady Perez, top of the key. Drives it left against Roberts. Gives to Nye. Nye kicks it out to Leininger. Leininger left side at the free throw line. Backs it out to the 3-point line. Now to the volleyball line on the right wing. Out to Perez on the left side of the floor. Right wing to Nye. Nye law pass inside. Taken away by Kresick. And gives to Beaver. Now to Roberts. Culver runs. Up by 9. Roberts coast to coast. Down low to Carnegie. His layup is good. And now the Cavs up by 11. Their athleticism taking over. Leininger loses the handle. But right there's Utter to pick up the loose ball.
Length and strength. Kind of overwhelming the Zebras a little bit here. Going to call a little hip check on Carnegie, his third. Team's first.
Well, the official here right in front of the Rochester bench keeps looking at the coaches, the assistant coaches, who must have been hollering there for a foul. And he finally called it before he whistled who it was on, looked at the bench like, you know what, fellas, I got it. I've been doing this a couple days.
Not. Let's just put it this way. Not an official that likes to be questioned.
Challenged. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's put it this way.
We've had him once already this year.
Yeah.
Here.
A few times through the years. Yeah.
Yeah. 31-20. Culver up. Nye on the right wing. Left wing. That is. Downloaded Plummer. Plummer gets away with a walk. Misses the shot. Picked up by Kresick. And the Cavs. 5:15 to play in the third quarter. Culver by 11. And with the basketball now going to our left, Rochester in a man-to-man defense. Deshaun back in the game. Gary Plummer is back in the game for Rochester. I'm not sure how many quarters he has, but he's on his second one.
Kresik.
Feels like he played just two quarters. I don't know.
Kresik, leaner is off the glass and in. Got around Plummer on the blocks. Used his body to defend or to shield the shot.
Yep.
And went up for two. It's a 13-point lead.
Veteran move.
Yep.
Upperclassmen take advantage of the underclassmen.
Lob pass to Plummer off his fingertips. Now taken away by Roberts. Roberts on the run, right side. Goes up, layup is no good, but we're going to have a charge. I believe we're going to have a blocking foul on Ryle. We'll wait and see who that's going to be whistled against. No. The bucket is good. No. You can't count that bucket.
He's calling the basket was good, but not on the shot was there a foul, but he got Brady to push the guy trying to get around. So the basket was good, but the foul was on the ground.
Timeout, Rochester. It's a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI at RTC TV4. To play in the third quarter. The Cavs now by 15, and that foul was whistled against Brady Perez.
Yes, it was. So it's his second, team's third, and Culver's going to maintain possession.
Yeah.
So the action of the shot was good. That's not where the foul was. The foul was a push, so Culver will maintain possession. Could be a 4 or 5 point possession here, which is not good because Zebra's down 15 all of a sudden.
Ryle gets the inbounds pass to Beaver. Beaver on the left wing, dribbles top of the key. Hands off to Harris. Harris drives in the paint. Ryle, his leaner off the glass is good. And once he noticed that 40 was in his path, he went harder to the basket knowing that Ben Perez has 3 fouls.
Yep, he's got 6-2 off the bench.
Deshaun on the right wing. Boy, Ben Perez looking hard down low on the block. Kresik not giving him any room to work. Utter now to Deshaun. Deshaun against the man-to-man defense. A couple of dribbles to his left, out of eye.
Off Jacob not. Bogging down. Nobody's really moving. You don't have anybody that can break anybody down off the dribble. There's no passing, cutting, or screening. So the Zebras aren't really getting anywhere at this point.
Nye high on the right side. Nye switches directions, goes to the baseline. Now to Utter. He'll take the 18-footer. It's short, and we're going to have a foul down low. Who's that going to be whistled against? Is that going to be on Beaver? It will be.
Yep. His third. Team's second and a half.
Schumann back in. Beaver to come out.
This is the big question mark. You know, where do the Zebras go for offense right here? Utter had a good look, but, man, you could see the frustration on his face. He's missed a couple threes. He's missed a couple twos. He's missed some free throws.
Deshaun for three is off the back of the rim. No good. And Ben Perez tips it out of bounds, going up for the rebound. It'll go back to the Cavaliers.
Great hustle by Brady just to make it to the play.
Yeah.
To make it to the ball. I didn't think he had a chance at it.
Well, Rochester needs a stop here down by 17. Yeah. They need a stop and a bucket. So Harris runs the point for the Cavaliers, walks it through the center circle, 3:40 to play in the third. Roberts, baseline to Schumann. Down low to Kresik, his layup is good. It's easy.
Yep.
Made it look easy anyway.
Zebra's got to separate. They're getting frustrated on offense. They're letting it affect their defense. And now they're not getting stops, and now they're not getting scores.
Rochester will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI at RTC TV4. .28 to play in the third quarter. The Cavaliers now out by 19 at 39-20.
We've seen this too before, right? Zebras not getting some offense. the offense is bogging down, then they're not getting stops on defense, and the next thing you know, a 7-8 point game mushrooms to a 19-point.
And they're starting to panic a little bit.
Yeah, the frustration, the panic, they're getting out of the rhythm, and thus the score is getting out of hand.
So Rochester has two timeouts, the Cavs three. 3:20 to play in the third. Deshaun against Roberts, high on the outside left. Now drives hard to the middle. Outside to Deshaun, feeds down to Ben Perez. Out to Deshaun. Zach, top of the key tonight. Jacob with the basketball, looking into the middle. Can't find Ben Perez. Deshaun now on the right wing, right in front of the Rochester bench. Now we're going to have a foul down low. Is that going to be on Kresik?
Not sure. Good call. It's his third. So now Beaver, Carnegie, and Kresik all have three. Deshaun and Ben Perez have three for the Zebras.
Liam Leininger back into the game, and Jacob Nye, I don't think has scored, but I think that he's played fantastic.
He's got three.
Oh, he does. Okay. Yeah. That's right. Three in the corner. He's played good defense.
Really scrappy game.
A lot of rebounds. Ran the point.
Yeah, he's kind of been an energy giver to the Zebras tonight, being very active on rebounds, loose balls, gotten other guys involved, looked up the floor even when he's gotten a defensive rebound, hit that one big three. Yeah, really impressed with Jake's four game tonight. Even though he's only got 3 points, he's doing a lot of other things to help the team.
Deshaun, baseline right, will look to get it in. And his pass is tipped back out of bounds by Harris, and he's got some springs. He got up quickly and batted that ball out of bounds.
Got a fake high and go low.
Now Utter will trigger it in. Austin looking, baseline right, still looking to get it in. Still looking to get it in, still looking to get it in. That's to Deshaun, back to Utter on the right baseline. Down to Deshaun, his lead on the way is off the glass, no good. Rebound to Cavaliers, Robert runs. Robert to the right side, hesitates now, accelerates around Leininger. Goes to the basket, he throws up a tough shot, foul on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Foul's going to be on Deshaun, his fourth, team's fourth.
Team fourth for the half, shooting two. Number
10. So going to the line is R.T. Roberts, a 6-foot junior for the Cavaliers, who lead by 19.
Roberts has 6 points, but he's also 2 for 5 from the free throw line.
One more coming for Roberts. Flies the second one, and it's in and out, no good. Offensive rebound by Harris. Leaner, no good. Roberts with the rebound. He backs out. He puts it in for two. And now the Cavs lead by 21 and 41-20. Stays, what was the break at halftime, or score at halftime?
26-20, my bad. 26-20. Yeah.
Right side or Utter. Yeah, you're not kidding.
Said
two and a half
drop,
to play.
Yes.
Ben Perez found in the lane. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Good strong move by Ben. Good post feed. Ben got a good low post position, got squared up.
Foul's on 32, Schumann.
So foul's going to be on Schumann, his first of the game. One of the few players that's played extended minutes not to draw a foul, but that's his first.
Dennis Williams.
Oh, yeah. Coach Williams.
Assistant coach on the bench.
Yeah.
About, I don't know, 7 foot.
Yep, he is listed 7 foot.
Played at
Grace with Bruce Grimm.
Also was playing in Fort Wayne in the semi-pro team.
Yep.
One of two that trip for Ben Perez and the rebound to Cavs.
He's working with point guards.
Yeah, he is. The run and jump defense. Cavaliers have it. Now ball stolen by Nye. Now Brady Perez has it. Brady, layup, good over the front of the rim. And the defense, the run and jump defense, force a turnover. Zebras down by 18.
Got to try something, guys. Disrupt this rhythm. Yep. Try to get back into it.
Harris in the corner to Stevens. One dribble against a double team, and now we're going to have a Culver timeout. It will be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. To play in the third quarter. The Cavaliers up 41-23. The Cavs right now riding a 15-3
run here in the third quarter.
Quick score, courtesy of Val. Marion 41, Mequonakwa 33. Marion won state last year at 4A, graduated a few guys. Mequonakwa is the boys'
Mishawaka
opponent.
Marion stays, yet, right?
No.
Marion, okay.
Yeah. Mequonakwa is who the guys play Tuesday night.
Oh, my good heavens. Rochester caught sleeping on the inbounds pass, and Schumann put it in for his ninth point.
Yeah, when you get frustrated, you stop talking. When you stop talking, you give up layups off inbounds. That's just a frustration lack of communication, which is a breakdown big time there by the Zebras on the out-of-bounds play.
Brady Perez high on the right side. The Cavs lead now by 20. We're late in the third quarter, 100 seconds to play. Nye has his pass swatted out of bounds by Harris, and it'll stay with Rochester on the far side. The Mechanical Brace, speaking of Mechanical, the guys have Mechanical next Tuesday in the first conference game of the year. We'll have that game for you here on WROI the same night the Rochester Lady Zebras will be home with the Culver Lady Cavs. Liam Leidinger to Nye. Inside to Utter. Utter at the left elbow. Fakes a shot. Gets a double team. Gets it out to Ben Perez, who gives to Leidinger on the right wing. A minute 20 to play in the third quarter. Utter against Royale. Utter drives it left at the free throw line. Down low to Ben Perez. Quickly to Nye. Three left wing. No good. And the rebound to Roberts for the Cavaliers. Roberts brings the ball up with 60 seconds. Roberts across the timeline, wide open to Ryle. Back to Roberts on the left wing. Fly pad down low to Stevens. Stevens against Utter, puts up a shot, it goes in. Carter Stevens, a 5'11 freshman in the books for the first time tonight. And it's back to a 22-point lead for the Cavs. Down to 40 seconds. Lining on the right wing, and now Coach Reinhold will use another timeout to 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Two seconds to play in the third quarter. The Cavaliers up 45-23. And another score to pass along to you in the third quarter. Warsaw defeating Tippecanoe Valley 49-22.
Also have Logansport 35, Peru 29 at half.
Rochester after their timeout of the basketball. Leidinger gets it in to Nye. 40 seconds to go in the third. Nye through the center circle against Harris. High on the left side of Brady Perez. Bounce pass is tipped away. Ben gets it back to Brady. Baseline to Utter. He travels. No call. Down low to Leidinger. Out to Utter on the right wing. Now to Leidinger in the right corner. Fakes the three. Feeds down low to Ben. Backs his way in. And we're going to have a travel. Whistle against Ben Perez. And it will go back to the Cavaliers with 19 seconds to play in the third quarter. Harris jogs it up the floor across the timeline with 13. Now to Roberts. Roberts against the double team. Now to Stevens with nine. Stevens is tied up, and Rochester going to get it back with 7.5.
Zebras going to the 2-2-1 half-court trap. Can be an effective defense, but it's one of those you've got to have all five guys dialed in and going full speed. It takes one or two, just one guy breaking down to give up a layup, but Zebras trying to change tempo.
4 seconds. Leidinger out to Nye with two, and then Harris bails him out with 1 second to play in the third. That'll be out of bounds to Rochester with 1.2 to play in the third.
Harris is second, is fifth.
45-23 Culver. Rochester will look for the final shot of the period.
You've got Utter, Jake Nye.
Nye's inbounding.
Yeah, Brady Perez can shoot it.
Brady Perez is going to have to shoot it. Nye looking to get it in. Nye looking, gives to Brady. Layup is up, no good, but a foul on the shot by Schumann. And Brady Perez will shoot two free throws with zeros on the clock.
Nice out of bounds play.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah. little misdirection. Brady set a screen and then just kind of looped around to the basket. Everybody was looking at Utter and all the screeners up top. And nice pass as well by Jake Nye right under the basket.
Yep.
Brady caught one up and drew the foul.
Brady Perez with two. Let the first one go off the back of the rim. No good.
Brady just coming back. Had some gallbladder surgery recently.
Second one is good. So after three, the Cavaliers lead 45-24. Fourth quarter next. 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Going to the fourth quarter with the Cavaliers leading 45-24.
I want to mention Abby McCarter, swimmer for Rochester, set yet another school record here this week. She has three individual school records and is part of three relay records. The young lady who's just a junior has a chance to maybe one, maybe two more records as well as adding to her own. So quite an accomplishment for that young lady. And I know the swimmers are expecting an outstanding season, and she's a big part of it.
Well, yeah, good for her. Congratulations.
Yep.
They swim Saturday by chance, do you know?
Probably.
Culver starts with the basketball. Beaver back in the game. The Harris high on the right side of Carnegie. We haven't seen a whole lot of Carnegie tonight, have we? Foul trouble.
Yeah.
Beaver saves it going out of bounds. The Harris saves it going out of bounds. And then back door to Roberts. His leader is no good. Woo! And then stolen by Harris. No look pass to Beaver. Layup is good. 47-24, Culver. Utter against Carnegie. Out of DeShawn. Zach DeShawn, crossover dribble, takes Harris left. Baseline to Ben Perez. His pull-up 10-footer, no good. Harris another rebound. Harris brings it up the floor. 47-24, Culver. Beaver in the paint. Kresick rises up, puts it in for two. Man. Defense, please.
Yes. Yeah. Too easy. Way too easy.
Nye across the timeline. A minute gone in the fourth quarter. Harris. I like him, Stace.
Mm-hmm.
Cash Harris, I like him. He is all over the place. Rochester is one timeout. Culver three. Under seven to play in the game. Culver up 49-24. Nye over the top of the defense to Brady Perez.
You can tell Culver's got a little bit better chemistry. They understand where the guys should go and where they're supposed to be and doing a nice job looking for each other. Their assists have been pretty impressive tonight.
Rochester throws the basketball out of bounds, and it'll go back to Culver on another turnover.
You know, there's a difference between trying to make a move to set yourself up and trying to make a move to maybe set a teammate up, and Culver's doing a really good job of finding and looking for each other, especially their interior passing.
Right, Culver just about throws it away, but Robert gets a loose ball. Down to Beaver, layup, good again.
Just helping up way too much. Can't help way up off the blocks. Every step you come off the block is one step closer to layup for the other team.
Yeah, good call. DeShawn hands off to Nye. Nye around the defense, works to the right elbow. Now behind the wing in the right, behind the three-point line. Out to DeShawn, lobs into Ben Perez. Ben backs his way in, kicks it out to DeShawn. Zach drives the left baseline, cut off by the defense. Now to Ben Perez, the left elbow out to Nye. 6-10 to play in the game. Nye drives, Brady Perez drives the baseline, wrap around pass to Ben. Ball loose, but there's DeShawn to pick it up. And his injury pass is taken away by Carnegie. The save him going out of bounds, right into the hands of Kresick. Now quickly to Harris. Harris goes coast to coast. His layup is good. And it's 53-24. Now Culver stays scoring at will and, more importantly, scoring within 2 feet.
Yeah, that's not a good sign. I mean, that's just lack of resistance a little bit.
And the quick three by DeShawn's no good. Roberts to Carnegie. Carnegie fakes, rises up. Shot no good. Gets a double rebound and put back is no good. But Utter commits a foul. That's going to send Carnegie to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, Culver just, you know, smells blood, just going for it. You know, just running the floor, beating the spots, and getting layups as a result.
Carnegie's numbers tonight?
He's got 6 points, 2 points, or 4 points in the first quarter, 2 points in the third.
Nate's first one is no good off the back of the rim. He'll have one more.
It's his first free throw attempt of the night.
Howard back in for Culver. Reininger back in for Rochester. Nye comes out. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Carnegie with one more freebie. Looking to push this lead to 30.
Carnegie kind of seems a little bit what Emma is for us. You know, Krusick is posting up, kind of what Kennedy does for us. And Emma's, you know, an athlete down there trying to make plays, and they do complement each other very well.
Brady Perez, jump stop, rises up in the lane, shot no good. Good block out by Krusick. He rebounds, gives out to Carnegie. Look out. Carnegie coast to coast, feeds down low to a wide open Howard. Cross lane pass, and it goes in for two, and it's 55-24.
Yeah.
And Coach Reinhold going to go to his bench.
Another example of sprinting down the floor, setting up a teammate. Nice pass. Could have taken a fourth shot, made a nice pass, set up an open teammate.
Butter on the blocks against the double team. Out to Deshaun. Three straight away is good. Zach Deshaun connects for three. 55-27. And Culver coming back quickly.
Zach's first points of the game.
Carnegie has a tip, but right there to Howard. Howard down low to Krusick. His layup is no good. And the rebound offensively to Roberts. Roberts in the paint. Gives to Carnegie. Floated off the glass. Nope. And the rebound to Leininger, who throws it away. Ball's tipped away. Now Culver has it to Roberts. His float on the way is good off the glass. Good heavens.
About five offensive rebounds.
I don't know. I lost count.
Yeah.
Ben Perez against Krusick, and he puts it in for two. Ben never put it on the floor, never brought it down to his waist, counted above his head and kept it up there. And now we have a travel on Beaver. Alex Unafield, a 6'3 sophomore, checks into the game. And Ben Perez, he is probably done, I'm guessing.
Ben, solid game. I mean, it's not easy battling against Krusick with his strength and Carnegie with his athleticism in there.
4:20 to play in the game, 57-29. Culver, Leininger goes hard to the basket. His shot's good and a foul. He needs to keep doing that. I like that.
Yeah. You see, that's the ability to drive and kind of create. Fouls on Carnegie, his third. Or sorry, Roberts, his third. Team seventh.
Leininger at the line to shoot one. Lane's free throw is too hard. And the rebound to Roberts. Roberts loses the ball. Ball still loose. And there's Unafield to pick it up. Gives to Utter.
Liam's got six tonight.
Leininger, left side to Deshaun. He drives left baseline, cut off by the defense against the double team. Down low to Unafield. Out of Utter. Utter. Baby hook, no good. And the rebound to Stevens for Culver to Roberts. Roberts ahead to Beaver high on the right side. Under 4 minutes to play in the game. Cavaliers in front, 57-31. Back door wide open to Beaver. Layup is good.
Got to pay attention on the weak side, too.
Yeah, boy. Deshaun, right side of Leininger, looks down low to wide open Brady Perez. Brady rises up off the window. Is good. 59-33. And now Culver will use a timeout. It will be a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. .23 to play in the game. Stevens goes to the basket. Call for the defense. Out to Howard. Howard back to Stevens in the blocks. Takes Unafield. He blocked it. Alex picks it up. Outlets to Leininger. 59-33 Culver. Leininger behind his back, dribbling outside to Utter. Long three, left wing is good.
All right, finally off the schneid. Maybe I'll get Utter going. You could just tell the frustration in him, just missing a lot of shots he usually makes.
Carnegie was fouled. Rochester, 16 foul.
23 Perez.
Fouls on Perez, his third, team's fifth.
His third, team six.
2:56 to play in the basketball game. The Cavs left 59-36. And after the foul, it'll be out of bounds to the Cavaliers right in front of their own bench going to our left.
Always got to watch when Utter takes a spill. I mean, it was back problems last year that knocked him out, and that was a pretty tough fall. I think he wears a little bit of a brace.
Okay.
For protection, but, you know, that's ask Tony Romo about bad backs.
Yeah. He gets to watch from the sideline.
Classy, though, for guys to, you know, just come out and, you know, say
Carnegie.
What he said, and hats off to Dak Prescott, but yeah, it was a classy move by Tony Romo.
Brady Perez strips the basketball. Perez, woo, deny, left-handed layup, nope. Rebound to the Cavaliers. Now the Cavs have the numbers, and smartly, Schumann slows up and gives it to Carnegie, to Howard. Howard to Beaver. Beaver on the right elbow, backs it out behind the three-point line. 3:15 to play in the game.
I think Cavaliers officials would really like to get out of here as fast as possible.
I think you're right.
Everybody knows it's Thanksgiving tomorrow.
Stevens, 10-footer is good. 61-36. Leininger, left side to Nye. Nye, one dribble to his right, and now we're going to have a foul down low, I believe, on Stevens. And that's going to send on a field to the line to shoot one of the bonus for the Zebras.
Stevens first, team's eighth.
Oh, Ben Perez is coming back in. Good for him.
Yeah. He's still working on rotations, still looking at some lineups and doing some things. Maybe on a field, Perez playing together a little bit. You know, it's been a while since you've been, well, I guess last year you had Bennett and Ben playing together as two posts, but.
Honeyfield's free throw is no good. The rebound put back by Hunter is no good. Gets his own rebound. Put back is no good, but if he'll go to the line to shoot two. I like the fight.
Yeah. Utter will battle. There's no doubt about that. Austin Utter is going to compete to the final buzzer. So that was good to see. And like I said, he's a guard, but he can battle in there, hang in there with big guys and create some offensive opportunities on some offensive rebounds.
Minute 54 to play in the game. Culver leading 61-36. Free throw by Utter short. Hey, our next broadcast will be Saturday night as the Rochester Lady Zebras are back in action and travel to Winnemac to battle the Lady Warriors. That's a
6 o'clock JV.
O'clock JV tip. 7:15 pregame here on WROI. Utter with one more for the Z's. Second for the juniors, good this time. 61-37 Culver. Rochester in a full court press. Schumann with the basketball. Splits a double team. And Rochester loses it. But Culver's right there to pick it up. Did Rochester have possession?
Yeah, Utter was trying to throw a behind-the-back pass, and it got away.
Schumann to the basketball. Now to Howard. Crossover dribble. Top of the key. Left side to Schumann. Goes to the basket hard. He's blocked by Ben Perez. Picked up by Leininger. And to Brady Perez. Brady rises up. Foul on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Foul's going to be on Bailey Howard, his first. Team's ninth.
90 seconds to play in the game.
That would have been interesting. Looked like Brady was trying to size up the steps.
I think you're right.
It's one thing to size up your steps when you're all alone, but there's going to be some traffic. It would have been interesting to see had the young man not fouled him, had he tried to raise up. That would have been impressive.
Oh.
Bank's always open, even this late at night. You got a debit card.
Brady Perez banks his first one in. And he'll have one more. Perez, second one on the way. This one's short. And the rebound to Schumann, who gives to Howard. 61-38, Culver with the basketball with a minute 20 to play in the game. Rochester going to open their season 0-1, and Culver going to be 1-0. Rael, with a minute 10, jumper on the way all the way from the Cavs is good. And it's 61-63, 38 with 60 seconds. Hunter quickly up the court. Now to Leininger, right side to Nye. Feeds down low to Brady Perez. Back to Nye, right wing, three on the way for the senior is no good. But we have a foul coming on Schumann. That will be after the shot. And Nye will go to the line to shoot two.
Yep, 10-team foul for Culver.
Number 32, Schumann.
9 different Cavs have scored tonight. The only one is the young man, number 11, Donovan. How are you going to say that name, Mus? Zaha?
Not gonna.
Okay. Donovan Z. But he just came in the game, so the 9 Cavs have scored.
9 at the line to shoot 2.
And 6 Zebras. Only 7 have played.
Yeah. Jake's first one is good.
6 fourth point.
Fowler comes out with 4 fouls, and back in is Beaver. 52 seconds to play in the game. Culver up 63-39, and Nye with 1 more for the Z's. Jake flies a second one. Hey, 2 in a row.
Yep.
Might be the first time all night by either team. Beaver ahead to Stevens. To Rael. His leaner on the way is no good. A lot of contact, no foul. Leininger with the rebound with 40. Ahead to Utter. 63-40, Culver. Utter on the defense. Out of Leininger, left side to Nye, feeds down low to Ben Perez. His layup is good.
Nice look, way to reverse the ball.
He in doubles?
Yes.
25 seconds.
13 for Ben.
Stevens, 15-footer right baseline, is no good. Austin, Utter with a rebound, out of Nye. 19 seconds to Ben Perez. Left hand, the layup is good again. 13. Howard with 10. Beaver with 8. Beaver around the defense. Has his pass tipped away and stolen by Perez. Ahead to Nye. Nye right-handed layup with 1, and that'll do it. The final tonight. The Cavaliers defeat the Zebras 63-46. Post-game show next, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV 4.